Get ready to dive into the thrilling world of gaming with PST, the narrative gamer. Ladies and gentlemen, today I'm about to take you on an extraordinary journey through the notable Holy Grail War story setting from Aster Tartaricus. With this fight, a mobile game, the story itself doesn't lose to that of Fire Emblem Three Houses, in my opinion. Even if memory are preordained to fade, can you still leave an indelible mark? Confronted with the inevitability of loss, when the moment demands, will you truly choose? The game plugs players into dystopian future on the brink of annihilation. As the inheritor of memories, the player avatar embarks on a mission to fend off the ancient monstrous onslaught known as Babaloi. The quest for the mystic weapon to salvage this world beckons the player to journey deep onto the annals of history, reliving the saga of protagonist named Nor from a millennium ago. In this ancient tapestry of Britain, the land is ensnared in a conflict between the Lorgas Kingdom and the Caledonia Empire. Nor, driven by vengeance for his father's untimely end, alongside his sister, Linata, have allied with the force of Caledonia. They serve as mercenaries unite in their quest to confront and defeat Lancelot, the most formidable knight of the Lorgas League. Nor was best in combat by the Knight of Laos, and to add insult to injury, he was defeated by Lancelot, his personal nemesis. Memories from the past flashback, his childhood, where he learned the art of swordsmanship alongside a young Lancelot, both under the teaching of Nor's father. Those were simpler times, filled with peace and harmony. Back then, Nor had inspired to join the Knight of Laos table, just like Lancelot and his father. His reminiscing was abruptly interrupted as he was jolted awake, finding himself confronted by a living nightmare. Soldier transformed into a monstrous creature called Babaloi, attacking allies and enemies indiscriminately. In the chaos, Nor rescued Guinevere, a young woman targeted by the Babaloi. To his surprise, she remarked on Nor's unique ability to defeat Babaloi without using the killer power. Short on cash but wanting to hire Nor for his skill, Guinevere offered him a selection of her lair for Lance coin as a temporary payment. Nor accepted. Suddenly, Lancelot appeared. "Why do you fight for them, Nor?" he asked, a hint of challenge in his voice. "I have been waiting for you." Anger boiled within Nor. "Waiting for me? You disappear with our word and now you say you have been waiting. Why did you kill our father?" "I am here with Dinathan to seek the truth from you." Without hesitation, Lancelot commanded his soldier, "Capture him." Nor met with Arthur and Kay, the Chancellor and Vice Chancellor of the Academy, respectively. They were both members of the Knight of Laos, and Arthur was the King of Lorgas himself. Arthur expressed his gratitude to Nor for saving Guinevere, his betrothed, at the behest of Guinevere, her sister, Grand Hubert. which I will call Gwen from now and Lancelot, nor not only free from incarceration, but also in dark as the night of now. Lancelot informed Nor that the truth he sought could be uncovered within the hollow hall of the Academia, marking the onset of Nor's academic journey. In this game, players can navigate the school ground in their leisure, reminiscence of the Persona game series. Player can choose to strengthen bond with friend, akin to social link, cultivate that persona trend, or partake in combat training. However, Nor start with a tarnished reputation, since he was previously allied with Caldonia. He shared a class with another Knight of Lao, Gawain, and his partner, Lucknell. In the canteen, Nor encounter Ulele. Just one glance at her make it evident that she is a class representative. Eager to assist, she proposed to help dispel the negative gossip surrounding Nor. Additionally, she familiarized him with the school amenity and educated him on its tradition and protocols. Kay harbors a notable distaste for Nor and contemplates expelling him from the school. Contrarily, Arthur suggests that Nor undertake a special test, a ritual with Sacre Blade Caliber housed in Camelot. Legend dictates that the sword resonates and bestows strength upon those destined to combat the Babaloi. While no individual has truly managed to extract the blade, numerous students, particularly the Knight of Lao, has been recipient of its power in the past. Guinevere offers her assistance to Nor for the ritual, given her past as the Princess of Camelot before it was seized by Caldonia. Her engagement to Arthur was forced as part of the plea for Loki's aid. Ulele shed light on the current predicament. Caldonia, control over the Babaloi has decidedly tipped the scale of war in their favor. Conventional weapons are futile against this creature, and without Lancelot's leadership, many have begun to lose hope. Meanwhile, concerned about Nor's well-being, Dina transcripts Claire and stumbles upon Maldisan, who engrossed in solitary performance despite their initial awkward encounter, and unlikely friendship blossomed. On their journey to Camelot, Nor and Guinevere's party confront a horse of Babaloi. Guinevere unveils her latent ability, initiating and gets tutorship with her sister, Gwent, morphing them into their combat attire. She explains that Babaloi are impervious to ordinary human attack. To vanquish them, one requires the mind of a killer, individual who have harmonized their essence with legendary weapon. Gwen, in the past, had become a killer through a ritual with Guinevere, who assumed the role of her wife or the master. Notably, the intensity of the bond between such partner amplified the power yield from a gestural ship. The Holy Blade Caliburn served as the catalyst for forging this profound contract. Their rare intrigue deepened as they ponder over Nor's unique capability to overpower Babaloi without harnessing the killer energy. Legend has it that the Holy Sword imprisoned the Babaloi for millennia, shielding the land ever since. Camelot was found with a singular purpose of safeguarding this sword, yet whisper about that the blade sapped the vitality of the land, rendering Camelot a balanced limb. Upon entering the church, Guinevere proceeds an offer to Nor. Should he unite force with her, he must commit to aiding in Camelot's salvation. Nor accepts. As the ritual commences, it becomes evident that neither Nor nor Guinevere is effective. The ceremony is seemingly fruitless. And to exacerbate matter, Babaloi, drawn to the ritual power, descend upon the church. Unbeknownst to the duo, Gawain and Lucknell has been covertly shadowing them. Now step forth and fend off the Babaloi onslaught, enable Nor to focus solely on the ritual. Despite Nor's fervent attempt to unlock the ritual mysteries, success eludes him. But then, an ethereal voice reaches out, hinting at a conversation with the very blade itself.
の剣を任して、マスター。
うっそ、
マジかよ。
マスター、マスター、長らくお待たせしました。
話の続きができますね。
君は
万物切り裂くサビズの魔剣、願いの代価はあなたの定め。
カリッパ
ー、歴史に記すはその呼び名ですが、我がオリジナルは
ファーストキラーズ、
ディルフィング。そう呼ばれていました。
ティル・フィング。最初の武器、君はキラーズなのか。俺の。
はい、マスター。あなたの初めての武器です。私はあなたを探していたのかもしれない。あなたの決意を受けたまわり、遥か未来の救いへ継ぎます。継承者の武器庫より、救いではなく刃となりて。
継承者？
汚れなき声を心に刻め、我が同胞の叫びをあなたに。
For the first time, Nor feels the stirring of his latent power as an interloper. Drained from the battle, he slumped into unconsciousness. Spiraling into the version of day long past, the memory unveiled a grim episode when Bruno was Bland the Valley Murderer, one of the most heinous truncations in all of Britain. Lancelot, in a desperate plea, has implored Nor mother and kin to escape.To suffer chore, even going so far as to secure a vessel for their getaway. Skeptical, young Nor had lifted the tale, but Lancelot solemnly recalled how he witnessed with his own eye Bruno slaying a fairy and then vanishing. While Lancelot intended to track Bruno down, he wanted to ensure the family's safety first. He also promised Nor place beside him at the Knight of the Round Table.Stirring from his slumber, Nor found himself in the infirmary, greeted by Morgan, Arthur's sister and the resident nurse of the academy. Now, with a burgeoning acceptance among the Knights of the Round Table, Nor's quest to cleanse his family name was just beginning. Arthur and Kay entrust him with multitude of tasks to further boost his reputation. In addition,Telfing was also inducted as a new student. She gently reminded Nor that while she stood at his initial weapon and ally, his two armaments lay concealed elsewhere. She held back from explaining more, fearing it could alter the fabric of his story. Curiosity piqued, Yunevia sought to understand the term fairy murderer. Gwen elucidated that during the time of great upheaval, the Holy Grail capable of granting any wish.Would manifest somewhere in Britain. To prevent it from falling into malevolent hands, Fairy would guide the Knight of the Round Table to its sanctified location. But in tragic turn of event, a nightly stand to chill one such valley, instead commit the unforgivable act of murder and flee. Ulele comment nor on his considerable progress in bolstering his reputation and on his also securing the killer. Gratefully, nor attribute much of his success to Ulele, who had proven an invaluable companion in navigating school life. He confessed his usual inaptitude in forging friendship independently. The two share a light-heart moment, their laughter echoing. Beyond the night of the round table and his classmate, Noor also has the opportunity to foster relationship with the utility characters, strengthening those bonds and will enhance functionality in the game. This includes access to weapon shop, item store, part-time job opportunities, and privilege of borrowing additional books from the library. Noor and Ulele bond deepen with time, their shared experience, both in academic endeavor and personal tales, brought them closer. Ulele revealed the memory lapse regarding her father, speaking of Babaloy's malevolent power to its identity. A victim eaten by Babaloy would forever ease from memory. Given Ulele's empathetic nature, she feared that the idea of being forgotten. Seeking to further connect, she proposed a casual outing to hear more about Noor's past. On their date, Noor divulged that he has allied with Caldonia upon hearing rumors of Lancelot murder his father. To his family has urged Lancelot to seek answer, not vengeance. Noor's pursuit of the truth had become overshadowed by his apprehension. Their intimate exchange was abruptly interrupted by an unforeseen Babaloy as saw on the academy. Springing into action, Noor engaged the creature, but Dinatan cry caught the Babaloy's attention. In a selfless act, Ulele choked Dinatan out of harm's way, only to be ensnared by a monster that claw.
やめろ！やめろ！
忘れないで。無理なの。分かってる。だけど約束。だから。お願い。お願い。忘れないで。忘れないで。やだ。忘れないで、忘れないで、忘れない。
Helfing has arrived. Overwhelmed with rage, Noor beckoned her to join the fight. But even their combined might struggle against the sheer number of Babaloy. The tide shifts with the timely arrival of the Knight of the Round Table, Tristan, Gawain, and Lancelot. The dust settles after intense skirmish. Dinatan, cocky and disoriented, recalls the chaotic moment leading up to her unconsciousness.
私、助けられたから。誰かに、助けられたはずなの。一瞬のことで、記憶が曖昧なんだけど。
ウレリーが、守ってくれたんだな。
え？
ウレリーが、その、身代わりに。
ウレリー？
お前を突き飛ばして、 助けてくれて。
ごめんなさい、兄さん。ウレリーって。
え？
教えて。誰のこと？
The subsequent morning.The Academia Community convened to discuss the unnerving Babaloy assault. Many marvels at Norfeet in eliminating a massive Babaloy. But earlyly, there was no mention of sacrifice or lost substance during the attack, nor anger how nobody mourned for those who lost their light. Lancelot explained the harrowing reality. Babaloy don't merely consume humans. There is memory and the very existence of their victim.Boosting their power and reproducibility. Even you found a letter written by the devout relative, you would feel as if it's belonging to a stranger. That evening, Dina Tan sought out Nor, yearning to understand the identity of her saver. She wished to share Nor's gift to bear the weight of loss alongside him. Grateful, Nor was also tormented by a haunting recollection of his last interaction with Ulleli.
あ、そうだ。バラさないでよ。嫌なんだよ。自分のことが根も葉もない噂になるの。
兄さん。
悪い噂にも、いい噂にもなりたくない。そんなの、本当の私じゃないから。
ごめん。言えない。
その人がいた跡が少しでも残ってると、みんな余計に苦しくなっちゃったりして。
どうして？
教えてあげられないんだ。
Alright, that's all for our Aster Tatalicus first story chapter. Did you like it?Please share your thoughts in the comment section below. I can't wait to read your all opinions and impressions. Thank you for joining me in this journey and I look forward to our future adventure together. If you enjoy this content, please show your support by liking and subscribing. Additionally, if you are interested, my Discord is now open to ask any question about this game. Join us as we embark on new adventure together. Until next time!